Yeah, what's going on, everybody? All right, so we got WWE news. I just want to say real quick that if you are watching this on delay or watching this on demand or whatever later on, I will be live tonight for the AEW review. So we will be live right here for AEW tonight. But this video is going to consist of all the wrestling news that's going on right now. And I know I've got a star on my nose. Lots of wrestling news out there to talk about a little bit. WWE canceling shows, COVID running wild in WWE. I'm going to get into some non-spoiler Matrix stuff in a few minutes as well. Just kind of hang out and talk about whatever, man. Whatever's going on today with you guys in the chat. It's up to you guys. Feel free. I know that 4 p.m. is always a bad time on a Wednesday to go live. Usually it's better for me if I'm live. My audience, you guys typically are around more around 11 and stuff. So this is not the best time to go live. People are getting out of work and things like that. And normally I'm at work myself, but, you know, I'm here today. HBO dropped The Matrix last night, and I was trying to go to bed at 1 or 2, and I couldn't get to bed. And then at about 2 a.m., I said, you know what? I can't hold it in. I'm staying up and watching it. And I did. I stayed up, and I watched it. I couldn't help it. I like The Matrix. I'll be honest. And I'll get into that in a few minutes. But I never saw the first movie in the theater. I actually didn't see it because I was annoyed by people talking about it. Similar to the way I'm annoyed with people talking about Spider-Man. Like, I almost don't care if I see it because I'm like, yeah, great. It's great. Okay, I don't care. That's how I am. I don't know why I'm like that, but I'm like that. So I never saw the first Matrix in the movies. But we'll talk about that later. Let's get the wrestling news in there. Maybe off the bat here. For a second, and then we'll get more into wrestling news during the stream if you guys want, depending on what questions you guys bring up or what comments you bring up about this wrestling news. A lot of WWE stuff has been filmed or taped or whatever already, so they're fine, even though there's what looks to be a pretty widespread outbreak in WWE of COVID. So, you know, what would put people on the shelf for 8 to 10 to 12, whatever days, they might get away with this, man. And the first thing I can say is this couldn't have... I almost feel like this sort of outbreak of the COCO is probably coming, I want to say, the best time. It's not the best time for people if they're going home to spend time with their families. I kept making the joke, Cove for Christmas. You know, I kept saying that. And I thought I was going to get it for Christmas. I had an envision of me being sick on Christmas with it. I had envisioned many people being sick with it on Christmas just because, you know, it's going around big time right now. You know, everybody's getting it. And if it's the Omicron version, apparently it's 2 to 3 times less, lethal or whatever you want to say of the other one. So that's good, I guess. If you're going to get one, get this one potentially. But, you know, these people are going to be going home to their families with it. So that kind of stinks. Or maybe not going home to their families. Maybe they're like quarantining in a hotel room before they go home. You know, I don't know. They could be doing that. I mean, that might be the smart thing to do. But yeah, we're gonna talk about things in a few. I'm gonna talk about The Matrix for the people getting in here. I'm not gonna spoil anything. No spoilers. I am gonna then do a spoiler full review. So as soon as I'm done with this live, I'm going to then do a full on spoiler video and put that up probably on Patreon and maybe on Evil Spectrum 3, my other channel. So look for those there. But what I will say is I liked it, man. And we'll see what happens on AEW tonight. A lot of speculation about what AEW is going to do tonight. This could be a big night for AEW. And we're going to see. WWE is canceling shows. They've canceled multiple shows already, and they could be potentially canceling more, it looks like. Now, I believe most of the stuff is filmed for day one, I think. I think that SmackDown is filmed as well. So they're going to get away with that because they filmed it already, I believe, from what I'm seeing. So that's good news that they got that out of the way. Because lots of people are going to be sick here coming up. WWE has canceled many live events in Canada mostly. So tickets for the December 30th show in Quebec no longer being offered. But the event is still listed on the schedules. In an update, WWE commentators Kevin whoever have confirmed the event was postponed. So that is postponed. December 30th in Canada. That's pushed back to March. We've had a few other ones, too, in the past. I don't remember now off the top of my head, but those were canceled. People were alerted. They were so early, they'd probably barely sold tickets anyway. So it wasn't a big deal, I guess. I mean, I would assume that you'd be... I'd be surprised if there weren't tickets sold for the January 4th and 5th shows that we were talking about. WWE talent and employees reportedly test positive for COVID at Fox special next, they say. COVID-19 Omicron variant is forcing tighter restrictions around the world. This is PW Insider Wrestling, Inc. WWE is once again dealing with significant issues related to the pandemic. A number of WWE talent and staff members were reportedly feeling run down last weekend's live event show tapings, and some have since tested positive for coronavirus, and that's according to PW Insider. While some have already tested positive, others are still waiting on the test results. So there's just a slew of people who haven't gotten their test results yet. Friday's Christmas Eve edition of SmackDown on Fox is already taped. Spoilers are already available. But the COVID-19 positives could have an immediate ripple effect on the return of the annual post-Christmas holiday tour, which is set to return this year after being nixed in 2020 due to the pandemic. So there you go. A note here from Wrestling Inc. and PW Insider. COVID-19 Omicron variant Fox has canceled their New Year's Eve Toast and Roast 2022 special. That was set to air next Friday night. This was the reason WWE SmackDown is being bumped to FS1 on New Year's Eve. It's been reported that due to the bump, WWE went with a year-in-review show for SmackDown that night. So SmackDown will be a year-in-review show. So just for all you guys, if you were making plans at all to think about watching SmackDown, you know, that might be a take-the-night-off type of situation. Fox has not announced replacement programming for the New Year's Eve show yet. That's why I think a lot of people thought maybe they'd run more WWE stuff, but they're not doing that. So there you go. Lots of canceled shows, lots of other things as well. oh, my God, Bob for Games. That's funny. oh, my God. They all get hepatitis from Hannibal. People who were there said they didn't film another show. That's definitely weird. So day one is not filmed. So if day one is not filmed, I thought day one was filmed. So day one is not filmed. I thought they panicked and filmed it. So if they didn't film day one, then that show, you know, potentially could be in trouble. Because I'm pretty sure Bianca Belair is one of the listed people to have allegedly have COVID. Is she not on the day one schedule? I thought she was. Maybe she's not. Yeah, she's not on there. So Roman Reigns, Brock Lesnar, neither one are rumored to have COVID. Big E, Seth Rollins, Kevin Owens, Bobby Lashley. There is a rumor that Big E has COVID. That's a rumor. I don't know. Kevin Owens, also a rumor. Becky Lynch, Liv Morgan, I didn't see their names. Edge versus The Miz, didn't see their names. Drew McIntyre versus Madcap Moss. I mean, I don't know if there's another match that I'm missing out on, but, you know, it could be in trouble. If that's live, then it's in trouble. Bianca isn't booked for day one, so we don't have to worry about her. I did see her name on several different lists. Red Comet Man, what's up, dude?
Super Chat Party!
Yo.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, Joe, did get that Jess Ventura video I sent on Discord?
Oh, my God, no. I haven't opened Discord in a couple of days. I'll have to pull it open and see what you're talking about. What video of mine did you send out? Was it the one about the world ending?
How about that? I should have been in the Matrix as a Navy SEAL because I was one. That's hilarious. Okay. COVID fears Lesnar. Okay, so like let's move on from let's get it. So we talked a little bit about the WWE events being canceled. You know, a little bit about day one. We're worried, waiting to hear news on this, more leaks or news or something to pop out about this. I assume it will come out as soon as I get off the air today. But it looks like WWE is trying to power through this thing any way they can, even if it's manipulating the system. If the both competitors agree to wrestle, then they get tested right after, which doesn't make any sense. But, you know, if you want to skim around the thing and do the deal, you can do it. I also want to apologize for my comments. This is such a horrific story, I can't believe it's real. Mom has arms ripped apart and dies, stopping a pit bull from attacking a four-year-old. Her son was attacked by the pit bull, and she stopped the dog and had her arms ripped apart. I mean, dude, it's such a horrific thing and horrific story that I can't even take it seriously because I can't believe that that's real, you know? So I wrote, mostly peaceful dog, you know? Because it is, by the definition of people out there nowadays. It was a mostly peaceful dog, which is, that's okay, you know? But I want to touch on the Matrix real quick without spoiling anything. So there's all your wrestling tour news. I have a couple other wrestling stories that I'm going to get to here as we continue to talk here. But so the Matrix. All right, I just want to start by saying real quick because I'm not going to go too much into it because I'm going to go do a full review with spoilers, and I don't want to spoil here. I like the movie. And which is crazy because every reviewer I know bashed this movie so far. But there were so many layers of messages in this movie about things that it's kind of wild. And if you're just going in to watch a movie, like The Matrix, I feel like if you're not catching these messages, then that doesn't mean anything to you. And if you don't care about the story of Neo and Trinity, then you also won't care about this movie. Because the action in this movie is, I thought it was all right, but it's nothing like the original. First of all, it doesn't have the exact same flow, right? It just feels like the Matrix done action nowadays. Whereas I enjoyed the way action was then, and it was also fun when the Matrix came out because it was different and new and bullet time and stuff. So that wasn't there. There was a million things that they could have sort of made easier or clarified. There was a lot of flashbacks going on, and there was too many flashbacks. There was just always flashbacks of flashbacks. And there was too many. There was just too many flashbacks, in my opinion. But the point of the movie is that there's a whole bunch of, like I said, sort of like hidden things and different messages inside the movie. And if you don't know that and if you don't get that, then you're not going to, like, understand. You know what I mean? You're not going to you're just going to be like, I don't get that. I don't care about that. So, therefore, I don't care. You know what I mean? Like, you're not going to give a shit. And if that's the case, you'll probably hate them. You won't like it. You'll hate it. You'll think it's stupid. Whatever the case may be. You know, that's how you're going to feel about this movie. I had heard that there was some woke SJW stuff in it and at the end or something, and I didn't get bothered by what I saw. There's two things that I could definitely see were the things. And I heard some other reviewers mention it, and they said, oh, some people are going to be angry about that. And I went, uh-oh, I bet you I'll be angry about that. And then I wasn't. Wasn't angry about it. I mean, listen, Lana Wachowski, who directed The Matrix, became a woman. I mean, the Wachowski brothers were brothers, and then they became women. They're part of that whole, you know, community. And this movie talks a lot about being who you are. You know, I mean, like, not hiding who you are, you know, not living in a matrix, you know, and trying to go by whatever. You know, that's always kind of been there in the movies. But you know, this movie really spends time in different ways, but they're sort of like messages that are hidden in this movie. So, I don't know, man. I noticed it all. There were comments about the yin and the yang, but there was lots of comments about the yin and the yang, but then there were also comments about how we're all together and we're all one. But that wasn't in the movie. It was in the background in these little commentaries and things and these metaphors and mentions and things that I was starting to pick up on in the movie. And I'm like, oh, dude, there's even one part where Neo is walking. And as he's walking, he blocks a sign. And because he's blocking the sign, instead of the sign saying Machina, the sign says China for like a long time. So while he's walking, I was staring, and all I saw was China, like in big letters, like right there. And I'm like, did they do that on purpose? And what's the meaning of that? And I couldn't figure out the meaning. Or is it just a coincidental thing? But he specifically walked in front of the camera, in front of the first half of the word, Machina, and all I could see was China. For like a prolonged amount of time. And I was not really, but like enough time that it was like China, China, China. And then like it went away. And I'm like, holy shit, bro. There's just all these goofy things. No one I talked to noticed that, but maybe it was just coincidental. I don't know. I don't even know what that means anyway, but it's just like, is there something there that I'm missing? So I don't know, man. I like the movie. When Jada Pinkett Smith had a line, one of her first lines actually cracked me up, and I liked her. I'm seeing people roasting her. I'm seeing people hating her or not liking her and saying she was terrible. I don't know why I didn't feel that way. I actually liked her. It felt good to see her in her, what she did in this movie. I was like, it was a connection to the older movies that helped me a little bit. That's me. You know, I don't know. People didn't like this movie though. I mean, I don't think so. This movie as a movie isn't that good. As a movie, movie's like a 6 out of 10 as a movie. But because of my emotion, I'll be dead honest with you. As a movie, this movie's like a 5 or a 6 out of 10, probably a 6 out of 10 maybe. But emotionally, I'm giving it a 7. And it's just like Ghostbusters to me. It's almost like The Force Awakens, Ghostbusters, or this movie. And you know, another thing this movie reminded me of, it reminded me of 80s sequels. Think of an 80s sequel. Do you guys remember 80s movies and early 90s movies sequels where they sort of did the same thing as the first one again, but like different? That's what this reminded me of. You know, the second Matrix and the third Matrix, the one thing you can say is they didn't do that. You know, because we weren't in that period of time. In the year 2003 and 2004, we didn't do the 80s sequel thing anymore. You know, by the mid-90s or so, they stopped doing that, which was always like, here's Back to the Future 1. Okay, now here's Back to the Future 2, but it's basically just sort of rehashing the steps of the first one in a different way. You know, that was a classic 80s thing to do in movies. They didn't do that in the second and third Matrix movies. They continued the story in a different way. This movie, in my opinion, is the closest thing to that sort of 80s situation. The only difference is there was a second and third movie, so you have to see all three to know this movie. If you didn't see The Matrix 1, 2, or 3, this movie is... You know, there's going to be a big gap in care for you. You know what I mean? Because as a movie, again, this movie isn't very great as a movie, right? The first Matrix is like an 8 out of 10 or an 8.5 out of 10. Maybe you think it's a 9. Maybe you think it's a 7. I don't know. But the first Matrix movie, we can all agree, is the best one. The second and third ones kind of fall off in a weird way, but I still like them. They're just bizarre a little bit and a little bit troublesome, but I still like them. And this movie is, like, if The Matrix 1 is an 8, this movie's like a 5, you know? But there's things in the movie that matter. And by the way, Neil Patrick Harris, Doogie Howser, you may know him from Doogie Howser. You may know him from How I Met Your Mother. Whatever it is you know Neil Patrick Harris from. I loved him. I thought he was fucking phenomenal in this movie. I don't know how people could not like him. I thought he was kind of wonderful in what he was doing. I liked him. But it did feel like a made for TV movie Matrix. Like it didn't feel on the scope of the other Matrix movies. I don't know why it felt like disconnected somehow. It's the same way Ghostbusters felt to me too, though. Again, Ghostbusters, I liked it. But yet all the movie reviewers that I know and I trust said it wasn't really that good. They were like, I guess it's better than the girl one because that was so ridiculous, but it wasn't that good. But, you know, I saw it and it was all right, I guess. That's what people said from the movie reviewers I watched. They were like, yeah, it wasn't the best. There was a lot of problems. I don't know why they didn't do better, but it was some nice parts and that was it. That's what I got out of Ghostbusters from people. But I actually loved it. I loved Ghostbusters Afterlife. I thought it was really good. But as a movie, it's not the best movie because they just sort of rush things. They go member berries. They rush things. But the emotional part of Ghostbusters that happens at the end and even during the movie is what I like. I like it so much, I'll give it a better rating because they made me emotional about the movie. I feel the same exact way about this Matrix movie. But there's a lot of problems, sort of, and there's a lot of things they could have done better. There's a lot of why did they do this instead of why didn't there's a lot of things that I feel like they could have done they could have slam dunked and they didn't. They sort of like rather than slam dunk, they were just like, here, take a shot. Yeah, here, take a free throw. You know, it's why didn't you dunk it? You could have dunked it. Why didn't you dunk it? You know, you took a free throw. Why'd you take a free throw? Don't dunk the ball. So that's the issue. But what one thing to me that's contentious is I came out of the movie thinking I don't have a problem with what they did. You know, and I think that for some people are going to see this movie as, oh my God, it's Last Jedi all over again. They went woke. But other people are going to not feel that way. And I don't feel that way. I'm not, you know me, I hate SJW crap. I hate the Hollywood garbage that they do. But I also know Lana Wachowski really has become a woman. And I know that she's got this philosophy that's wild. Now, I think Lily Wachowski is the more toxic. Lily Wachowski's Twitter is filled with, like, you know, end Republicans and all kinds of crazy stuff like that. But I mean, but Lana, hers is fine. So I actually like Lana Wachowski. At least I like her. Lana Wachowski, like, is into all these crazy books about dimensions and how we're connected and Buddhism and monks and what the universe is made out of and the numerical code that's out there and how we're all, how we react to our world. This movie, The Matrix 4, it is fully meta. It is so meta, it's unbelievable. It is, like, violently meta. In this movie, they literally talk about making fun of The Matrix. They literally talk about how we're going to make fun of it. In the movie, they actually talk about how we're going to say it's woke, how we're going to say it's not, how we're going to say it's too woke, how some people are going to say it's not woke enough, how some people are going to get bored of it and hate it, how some people are controlled by it. Like, there's so much, like, meta in this movie about how we're controlled by the government, how we're controlled by our phones, how we're controlled by our technology, how we're controlled by our not being who we are, whether that's you're with a woman you shouldn't have married, you want to come out as gay but you haven't, you know, you're afraid to be who you are. There's all these messages in this movie, but they're not in your face. But the fourth wall breaking meta-ness is all there, right there, just in your face. But the comments about who they're talking about when it comes to be yourself and that we're all connected as one in a way, those aren't in your face and they're not beaten over your head. They're just there subliminally in the background. But the reason why I'm not offended by it at all is because, number one, they don't beat you over the head with it. Number two, it's not a main thing that you have to worry about. And number three, it's because it means everybody. It doesn't matter, straight, LGBTQ thing, whatever it is. It doesn't matter what you are. It's talking about you, no matter what, whether it's your job, whether it's your wife and husband, it's your life, whether it's that you never did the thing you wanted to do in life, whatever that is, it's equal to everybody. You can apply it to yourself because they haven't applied it for you in the movie. They're not subliminally applying it for you. They're subliminally offering it to you in the background. But whatever you are and what you deal with, you're going to, because I think this is what the movie does right, it allows you to apply your own circumstances to what they're saying, like fill in the blank type of thing, without doing what a lot of other movies would do, which is fill in the blank for you. Tell you why you should feel bad for this certain person or certain type of person and why you're bad if you don't. It's nothing like that. It's not pointing fingers. It's actually accepting, waiting for you to fill in the blank. How, whatever that is for you. Maybe your life is perfect for the most part. And you're just control. Maybe you spend too much time on your phone and that's the thing that you're connecting with. Or maybe your life is perfect, but you can empathize with other people who deal with this. Then you'll fill in that blank that way. Maybe you're someone who's going to be coming out gay soon, but you didn't because you're worried about your life. That's going to be where you fill in your blank. Maybe you're someone who's been with an abusive husband or wife or somebody, and you don't know why you're still there, and you need to tell them and come out of it. You know, that's your fill in the blank. It's all there for you to fill in the blank because that's what's there. But as a movie, it's not going to be that good, right? As a movie, and most audiences aren't going to ever pick up on the things I just said. What I just said, it's going over everybody's head. No one's even going to realize that. But as a movie, it has many, it has some flaws. It does a lot of repeating of the other movie. And so therefore this movie is not going to do so well, unfortunately, because I liked it. And I see that it's not going to do well. If you're somebody who doesn't care that much about The Matrix, you're probably going to go in and see it and think, I don't really get it. It was okay, I guess. But you're not going to care about all these references and the emotion of things. You're just going to be like, okay, that was interesting, I guess. I don't know. I don't really care about The Matrix. So if you don't love the first three movies, it's going to be hard for you to even like this movie. You're going to be like, that was kind of interesting, I guess. I don't know. When's Spider-Man coming out? And if you're somebody who loves action movies, you're going to be like, okay, I thought the first three Matrix had better action, so I guess they did some action. That was kind of cool, but not really. John Wick is better, you know? So you're out, right? So that's two, you're out. Then if you're somebody who cares about movies making a lot of sense, you know, there are times where it doesn't make a lot of sense and it jumps a bit all over the place in ways that are weird to me in movie form. So it's not a very good, well put together edited movie. Or it's not that it's not well, it's like a B-, but it should be an A+ for a Matrix movie. So that it falls on that too. And if you're into the story, it's one of those things where it's like they did all this for a story, which is fairly familiar, but has a difference to it. So the mystery of what's going on in the story and will this some things happen is really what only drives it until the end. And so if you're invested in that, then I think you'll have a decent time. So there's my review. I think you might have a decent time watching The Matrix. I myself, again, because I'm emotionally attached to these movies, I found them, I loved it. I mean, I liked it. But I know it's one of those things where it's like, I know it's not that good, but I loved it. If that makes any sense. It's like, I like bands that play power chords and aren't that good musically, really, right? Like, they're not crazy guitarists, but I like it, so that's all that matters. I mean, it was a little fan servicey. It was a little fan service. It was like Ghostbusters. That's all I can say is, to me, it was like Ghostbusters. It was like, remember this, that, remember this, that, remember this, that. And then there's a sweetness and a sweet little payoff in the movie. Because, you know, at the end of the third movie, you know, there's a payoff there. And, you know, it adds a little twinkle of layer onto the third movie. So anyway, my point is, I'm giving it a 7 out of 10. I think a lot of people are going to give it a 6 or a 5. I'm going to give it a 7. And but what I'm happy about is that it wasn't a Picard. It wasn't a Last Jedi to me. It wasn't a fully woke piece of trash. There are so many hidden meanings in this movie, or like messages in this movie, that are just, I got to watch this movie like 7 times to get it. Hella purple pill, says Salami. That's fucking hilarious. What's up, Bruce Davis? How you doing, man? That is really funny.
Super chat party!
Oh, yeah?
Play video at LOL.
Oh, yeah, let me check that out, Mr. Pico. Hold on one second here. Let's drop back to my... You want to know about the wrestling news real quick and the cancellations? Let's get to those real quick, and then I will go back to closing this out. Like that. And normally, I'm at work, and if it's the Omicron version, apparently it's 2 to 3 times less hot, you know, lethal, or whatever you want to say, of the other one. So that's good, I guess. If you're going to get one, get this one, potentially. But, you know, these people are going to be going home to their families with it. So that kind of stinks. Or maybe not going home to their families. Maybe they're, like, quarantining in a hotel room before they go home. You know, I don't know. They could be doing that. I mean, that might be the smart thing to do. But, yeah, we're gonna talk about things in a few. I'm going to talk about The Matrix for the people getting in here. I'm not going to spoil anything. No spoilers. I am going to then do a spoiler fold review. So as soon as I'm done with this live, I'm going to then do a full-on spoiler video and put that up probably on Patreon and maybe on Evil Spectrum 3, my other channel. So look for those there. But what I will say is I liked it, man. And we'll see what happens on AEW tonight. A lot of speculation about what AEW is going to do tonight. This could be a big night for AEW. And we're going to see. WWE is canceling shows. They've canceled multiple shows already. And they could be potentially canceling more, it looks like. Now, I believe most of the stuff is filmed for day one, I think. I think that SmackDown is filmed as well. So they're going to get away with that, because they filmed it already, I believe, from what I'm seeing. So that's good news that they got that out of the way, because lots of people are going to be sick here coming up. WWE has canceled many live events in Canada, mostly. So tickets for the December 30th show in Quebec no longer being offered, but the event is still listed on the schedules. In an update, WWE commentators Kevin whoever have confirmed the event was postponed. So that is postponed. December 30th in Canada. That's pushed back to March. We've had a few other ones, too, in the past. I don't remember now off the top of my head, but those were canceled. People were alerted. They were so early, they'd probably barely sold tickets anyway. So it wasn't a big deal, I guess. I mean, I would assume that you'd be in... I'd be surprised if there weren't tickets sold for the January 4th and 5th shows that we were talking about. WWE talent and employees reportedly test positive for COVID. Fox special next, they say. COVID-19 Omicron variant is forcing tighter restrictions around the world. This is PW Insider Wrestling, Inc. WWE is once again dealing with significant issues related to the pandemic. A number of WWE talent and staff members were reportedly feeling run down last weekend's live event show tapings, and some have since tested positive for coronavirus, and that's according to PW Insider. While some have already tested positive, others are still waiting on the test results. So there's just a slew of people who haven't gotten their test results yet. Friday's Christmas Eve edition of SmackDown on Fox is already taped. Spoilers are already available. But the COVID-19 positives could have an immediate ripple effect on the return of the annual post-Christmas holiday tour, which is set to return this year after being nixed in 2020 due to the pandemic. So there you go. A note here from Wrestling Inc. and PW Insider. COVID-19 Omicron variant Fox has canceled their New Year's Eve Toast and Roast 2022 special. That was set to air next Friday night. This was the reason WWE SmackDown is being bumped to FS1 on New Year's Eve. It's been reported that due to the bump, WWE went with a year-in-review show for SmackDown that night. So SmackDown will be a year-in-review show. So just for all you guys, if you were making plans at all to think about watching SmackDown, you know, that might be a take-the-night-off type of situation. Fox has not announced replacement programming for the New Year's Eve show yet. That's why I think a lot of people thought maybe they'd run more WWE stuff, but they're not doing that. So there you go. Lots of canceled shows, lots of other things as well. Oh, my God, Bob for Games. That's funny. Oh, my God. They all get hepatitis from Hannibal. People who were there said they didn't film another show. That's definitely weird. So day one is not filmed. So if day one is not filmed, I thought day one was filmed. So day one is not filmed. I thought they panicked and filmed it. So if they didn't film day one, then that show, you know, potentially could be in trouble. Because I'm pretty sure Bianca Belair is one of the listed people to have allegedly have COVID. Or is she not on the day one schedule? I thought she was. Maybe she's not. Yeah, she's not on there. So Roman Reigns, Brock Lesnar, neither one are rumored to have COVID. Big E, Seth Rollins, Kevin Owens, Bobby Lashley. There is a rumor that Big E has COVID. That's a rumor. I don't know. Kevin Owens, also a rumor. Becky Lynch, Liv Morgan, I didn't see their names. Edge versus The Miz, didn't see their names. Drew McIntyre versus Madcap Moss. I mean, I don't know if there's another match that I'm missing out on, but, you know, it could be in trouble. If that's live, then it's in trouble. Bianca isn't booked for day one, so we don't have to worry about her. I did see her name on several different lists. Red Comet Man, what's up, dude?
Super Chat Party!
Yo.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, Joe, did get that Jess Ventura video I sent on Discord?
Oh, my God, no. I haven't opened Discord in a couple of days. I'll have to pull it open and see what you're talking about. What video of mine did you send out? Was it the one about the world ending? How about that? I should have been in the Matrix as a Navy SEAL because I was one. That's hilarious. Okay. COVID fears Lesnar. Okay, so like let's move on from let's get it. So we talked a little bit about the WWE events being canceled. You know, a little bit about day one. We're worried. Waiting to hear news on this, more leaks or news or something to pop out about this. I assume it will come out as soon as I get off the air today. But it looks like WWE is trying to power through this thing.
Power through it.
Anyway, go ahead and keep powering through it, WWE. I'm back. I'm back live. What's up, everybody? Sorry. I spilled coffee all over the floor like an idiot. Whew, I was trying to rush so much. Let's see. You worthless loser. That's Hannibal, right? That's you're a worthless loser. You got to get the vax to see the Matrix? Oh, really? Hey, Bruce, have a good Christmas, man. I hope you guys all have a good Christmas, man. Thank you so much for the dono. Red Comet, man. I'm supposed to be going to SmackDown 1722, Mohegan Sun. Oh, shit, Ryan. Oh, shit, is it in Mohegan Sun? I didn't know that. Maybe I'll go. I loved seeing SmackDown at Mohegan Sun the last time. Of course, Road Dogg gave me those tickets, so I don't know if I'd pay for tickets. Yeah, I wouldn't. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. I was still waiting for more wrestling news to drop because I just figured something else had happened. WWE NXT viewership and key demo rating for AJ Styles' special appearance. You want to hear it? We got it. We got that rating popping. Not very good. Let's see. What were they at the week before? I don't know. They are up a little bit, but obviously that was sort of expected. You would think AJ would draw at least 10,000 people, you know, or something. Here's the numbers converted via Wrestling Inc. I want to give them some love via Showbuzz Daily. They drew 591,000 viewers. That's up 5% from last week's 561,000 viewers. So AJ Styles, at least you could say, possibly drew 30,000 people. You know, give or take. So, and I don't know what Rampage is at, 500,000. So now NXT isn't competing with AEW Dynamite anymore. They're competing with Rampage, really. Because Rampage gets like 490,000 people or whatever it is. And, you know, Dynamite gets like 900,000, somewhere between 850,000 to a million, which again, you know, we expected those numbers, I thought, to go up above a million and kind of stay there. And unfortunately, that has not been the case for AEW. They're, for whatever reason, no matter who they add, no matter who they bring back, that viewership always goes, just falls back down to a million, to 900,000, to 800,000. They just can't sustain something over 1.2 million or over 1.1. I don't know why that is, but it just keeps being that way. And so, you know, I don't know what the answer to that. It's obviously not star power, I don't think, because there's no, they have star power. Oh, shit.
Okay, here we go. Everyone knows I'm out the window. Yep. Yo, motherfucker, no romance, cause there ain't no chance in my happy pants. Could you perchance come and take this dance and leave me here? I'm a bad motherfucker.
All the way from the UK, Brian Jardine. What's up, man? You might be from where I'm from, man.
Put it in a happy rhyme, motherfucker.
Are you from,
It's Gluck Club.
I'm from the UK,
bang,
damn it.
Bang, TikTok.
Fucking suck.
Oil shock. Two on consignment, on one in stock. What's the time, motherfucker? Said Gluck Club. I said Gluck Club.
Have a good Christmas, Joe. Love from UK.
Hey, thank you, Brian. Merry Christmas, man. Have a good Christmas. I hope you do, too. Wow, dude. Thank you so much, dude. $30 drop. Coming in with the euros. They got to be worth more than the American dollar at this point, by a bunch. What's the euro at? Let's see. What's the exchange rate on that? Oh, $33. So yeah, it's a little. So it's $33 American. So I guess our money's still worth more, but it's pretty close. Right? So that's not bad. Yeah, $33 American is $30 euro. It's 30 euros. Interesting. Thank you, Brian Jardine, man. What's been up? I'm 40% from Britain, right? Where's my ancestry.com? I got to be careful. I always say incestry, and it's like, people are like, what? You're into that? And then I'm like, oh, no. No, I meant ancestry. Like, sorry. But yeah, it's... Oh, let's see if we can get him. I'm out there somewhere in Europe. Are you in Wales? Maybe you are, maybe you aren't. I don't remember. You're in Wales. Hey, they've added some new data and improvements. Oh, now I've got a hit in Greece. Now I've got some hits in Greece. Let's take a look here. Where's my Chad Africa? Here's my list right here. 34% England and Northwestern Europe. 28% Scotland. 9% Wales. 9% Ireland. 8% German Europe. Northern Italy 5. France 5. Aegean Islands? What the fuck is that? I've never seen that before. What the hell is that? Primarily located in Greece? I've never heard of this place. What the hell is this? Has anybody ever heard of this place? Spread throughout the Aegean Sea? I never even heard of this. Turkey and mainland Greece islands region, which includes Sporadus. How come I've never heard of these places? That's why I can't pronounce them. What the hell? I gotta send this to Leah. What the fuck is this? I think these things are horseshit. Like at this point, I mean, I don't know. I'm an island boy. I'm like, let's go. I always wanted to be one. Now I really can say it. Let's go. Are you serious, guys? Come on. I'm an island boy. I can't believe I have 2% from this place. I'd never heard of this. I mean, I've heard of almost everywhere I'm from that I'm made up from. Let's go take a look. What the fuck?
Turkey has concerned about the violation activity of Greek soldiers on a tiny island in the Aegean Sea in 2020.
Aegean Sea.
20. With Turkish media featuring images of Greek soldiers arriving on the island, the foreign ministry in Ankara said, "We will not allow such a provocation just across our shores." In contrast, a person familiar with the Greek government stance said soldiers are already stationed on the island.
Jesus, sounds like a horrible place. This sucks.
No match. Scenery made for falling in love. No words. Dancing eyes of locals to welcome you. No equal. Aegean Islands, like no other.
What the fuck? What the hell, bro? I have no idea what's going on, guys, but I'm from the Aegean Islands. 2% from Aegean Islands. We're going island by... What the fuck, bro? That is so weird. That is so weird. Yeah, Ryan McLean, man, I totally understand why you wouldn't be watching a lot of wrestling. That's why half of this video has been about The Matrix so far. So weird, man. So, yeah, so okay. So that's interesting. 2% from Aegean Islands. Aegean Islands. And now Chad isn't on here anymore. Now my African heritage isn't here anymore, I don't think. Or maybe it is. I just got to click on other regions. It did take me a while to find it last time. But mostly England, you know. I've got those blue eyes. You want to see specifically where in England I get the most hits? This is it right here. There's a little hint over here in Belgium area. Leah's is like Ireland lit up crazy. That's wild. Well, that was fun, you know, learning a little bit every day. I think it's all, they might be making this shit up all the time. Clam Baked, what's up, man? Gonna watch The Matrix tonight. Gonna keep an open mind. It's hard these days with movies. Yeah. I think the only thing I can say, Clam Baked, is Lana Wachowski is a woman now. Do you know what I mean? So, you know, she does come from that sort of LGBTQ background in that area. But in my opinion, I just don't see this movie, these characters and stuff aren't destroyed. They aren't hurt. I really believe she loves these characters and that she loves, and that there's an actual message they're trying to say in these movies. But it's more about our reality and about control and about our lives. It's not about the Hollywood thing or whatever. Now, there's a line in this movie, and again, I'm probably going to talk more in spoilers later. I'm not going to talk about it now, but there's a line in the movie where someone says something like, to the effect of like, you know, maybe we could just paint everything, or maybe your whole life is just full of whatever. And it's a line that isn't a big deal at all. And it's like nothing. But like, that's the line some people are talking about. Like, oh, and dude, if I'm not getting mad about it, I don't think there's a reason to be mad about it. But that's me, because that's just me. I just don't think a lot of people will be mad about it. I don't think what I saw in this movie was, it's just a lot of stuff in this movie that I was like, they didn't really need to do that. They could have just not done that. And then there was some things where it was like, why didn't they do that? They could have just done that, and then that would have been better. That would have been pretty cool. But instead, they just sort of, I don't know. I wish that they'd addressed a few things. It's kind of like all the Wachowskis movies ever. They're always like this. There were things in V for Vendetta where I was like, if they had just done this or that, it would have been better. Even better. You know what I mean? If they'd explained things a little more in this way, like I would have understood this better. Same thing within Cloud Atlas, dude. In Cloud Atlas, there was a bunch of things where I was like, if they had just sort of explained this a little better, I would have liked the movie better. But in almost every goddamn Wachowski's thing, or in every Matrix movie, you have to go watch like 70 videos from somebody explaining what the fuck you just saw. I liked it. I liked this movie, though, because of all the meta stuff and because of all the subliminal stuff, and not even subliminal. It was obvious to me watching the movie. There were all these messages being said to you and comments on everything being said. And I found it amazing, kind of overwhelming. I got to watch the movie again just to write down the references to be like, oh, they're talking about that here, I think. And oh, this means that. There was a lot of yin and yang, but we're really together. You know, like everybody spends so much time on yin and yang, but we're really together. We really can do the same thing together. Like there was a lot of that message in this movie repetitively, but it was sort of hidden in ways that you could see, but they were in the background. There was all these little things, like, and I have to watch this again to figure it out, but I began getting excited about it in the movie. I was like, oh, shit. Then they broke the fourth wall and started talking about things the way all of us would talk about things, but they portray it in that light of, like, man, what's wrong with these people, almost. But they don't say that to you. They don't tell you that, but that's the way I took it. And there's so many things in here that you're going to take things the way you take them, and it's up to you how you take them, but they do exist and they're there. And there's all these little connections. You know what I mean? It's just crazy. There's a lot of things that are, there's a lot of things that if you're a two-dimensional thinker, you won't understand. I'm a two-dimensional thinker. I'm a moron, okay? It's just I was looking for things, so I saw them. But a lot of people, they're going to watch this movie. They're going to be like, I saw action movie Matrix. I don't get it. Whatever. Cool, I guess. Ah. Like, but if you are trying to look for some things, or if you understand things when you watch them, you'll be like, oh, I get that. But then if you're really looking, or if you're really somebody who sees like a three-dimensional, fourth dimension, or multidimensional meanings, words, and things like that, and layers to things, you're gonna jerk off, I think, to some of the stuff you see in this. I myself am not smart, and I'm also a two-dimensional thinker usually. So most of what I saw was, it was hard to figure out, but I knew there was something to it. And even now, I couldn't tell you what it is. I have to go back and watch again and again and maybe think about it or wait till someone else explains it to me. But I liked it. I got to tell you, I liked this movie for the most part. I thought it was a 7 out of 10, and I liked it, and I think it's worth your time if you have some kind of open mind. If it was woke or if it was, like, annoying or horrible, like, I would have been angry, and it wasn't. There's a couple things that could be mistook for woke, I guess, in it. That's my concern, is that some of the things that people are going to be like, ugh, they're not done to be woke, in my opinion. They're done because it furthers the narrative of we are one. There is light and dark. There is every equal opposite to everything, but yet all united, connected in a way. So I feel like that message, we're all under control by something potentially. There are things that we want to be that we can't be because of something. All of those messages, just part of them that were tied in there, I think are in there for a real reason and for an honest reason, because this is what the Wachowskis, you know, kind of always have thought about and brought up in their movies, and especially Lana in this movie. So I liked it. I am hyped for AEW tonight. A lot of people ask me about AEW tonight, and I am hyped. What up, COVID 1984? Yeah, I mean, the last two Matrix movies were a little rough, but I still like those too, though. So I don't know. I like them, even though they're like, as movies, there's a lot of problems. You know, they're not the best movies, like, as movies. But as these attempts at trying to drum up some sort of philosophical whatever, that works kind of for me because I get it, some of it. And then if I don't get it, it makes me think about what I'm not getting or what I could get or what does that mean. So I appreciate that. And then there's the emotion of the story that I also got connected with. But again, as a movie, not the best. You know? Yeah, I don't know, man. I know, I don't think we watched two different movies. I just think that it's all a perspective thing. But because I agree with you, COVID, that the movies aren't very good, like, as movies, that they've got some problems. I mean, dude, Revolutions or whatever, the last one was really bad in a way, but I liked it. So my point to you is I'm agreeing with you that it's a bad movie, kind of, or not a very good movie. You know what I mean? 5 out of 10, 6 out of 10 type of movie, but I like them. So I'm basically telling you, like, I agree, but for whatever reason, I like it. So that's all I'm saying, you know? Like, I agree with you, though. Typically, it wouldn't be considered a great movie, you know, for many different reasons. And this one is all, there's just all kinds of stuff in this movie. You know what I mean? Like, there's a lot of different things that could be going on. Neo. Trinity, I want to eat you out, Trinity. I love you. Oh, let me get into the CGI and the action here for Ramen. I just realized I was muted. I'm sorry. I was muted that whole time. I apologize. They were calling about the mask mandate. I guess we have a mask mandate in municipal buildings. Ramen. Okay, so yeah, so the CGI is all right, but let me put it to you this way. Another problem with this movie is the action. The action from the original three movies, especially the first movie, feels ahead of its time, innovative, and amazing. The action in this movie just feels okay. It feels like action that you could see in a TV show or a Netflix series. It doesn't feel very polished sometimes. There's some issues. There's mistakes in this movie. Editing is all over a little bit. Cut scenes. It's not the Matrix of the first three. So the another problem with this movie is the Matrix 1, 2, and 3 do action sequences better. The Matrix 1, 2, and 3 feel like bigger movies. They feel like better action movies, bigger movies, and more innovative action movies. This movie felt like, okay, we want to tell another Matrix story, but we don't want to have to go through all those days of filming like we did the last time. We don't want to, you know, we did so much then, we're not going to do that now. It's almost like, think about like Metallica's best album versus like Saint Anger. You're like, Metallica, why didn't you do all that awesome stuff you used to do? Why did you make the snare drum sound like dick? You know, it's sort of like that. It's like, well, you guys were the Matrix, man. Like, a lot of the point was how awesome and innovative all the things were. But nowadays, that's not impressive anymore. So I think Lana Wachowski was like, listen, that stuff, that bullet time thing and all those things we did, they're not that impressive anymore. Let me put it to you this way. In the movie, there's a new thing that happens in the Matrix, right? And it's actually cool and I like it and it plays in the movie really well. But even as cool as that new thing is, it's not as cool as, let's say, the scene from... Do you know the scene in, what was the scene everybody loved in X-Men? In X-Men, Future Days Past, whatever that movie was that was really good. Remember, everybody loved that movie? That scene where the guy can speed around and do all this stuff and whatever. I would say that like that's one of the best scenes in movies in the last like 10 years. Days of Future Past is the name of it. That's one of the best scene, like sort of fun action sequences of the last 10 years. And you know, I would say that an innovative, you know, that too, creative and innovative. And I think the last time we saw creativity and innovation like that was in the Matrix, you know, some of those, especially the first Matrix movie. That doesn't really happen in this new Matrix. It's sort of like a worser version of the Days of Future Past thing. And so, but I understand because, like, the story doesn't call for it. It doesn't need to be there. But I guess my point is, okay, the action sequences, they're all right and they're fun enough, but they're not memorable like the old ones are. But although I will say that the new thing that they do is a bit memorable, a little bit. But my point is they didn't spend all this extra time. They didn't spend an extra 100 days so they could shoot some crazy bullet time camera thing or whatever. So they don't need to do that, and they don't do that, but there's nothing new that blows anything new else out of the water. You know, there was no ambition to say, we're going to set the new standard now for anything, you know, because they're just not, I don't think the technology is at the level right now to do that, or at least it's not worth sacrificing 100 days of shooting in a budget to do it at this point for this type of movie, apparently. So in my opinion, the action isn't as good, you know, as the originals. That's just the way it is. And, you know, that's a big thing for a lot of people, I think. And then someone said, how is the acting? I think the acting is great. You know, I think it's funny because Keanu Reeves does feel like Neo for the most part. You know, he's a lot older and stuff like that, but he still feels like kind of like Neo. I believe his love and drive, you know, for, you know, whatever his passion is there, I think. Carrion Moss is good. I think it's all pretty good. There's nothing bad that I can see in really any of the acting. I don't think that some of the actors that played the new actors that played the old characters that we saw in the trailers, I don't think they needed to. I don't know why they couldn't get the old actors. There was no need and not enough explanation as to why, you know, new people were playing them. I felt like they could have dove a little more into, like, why people don't look the same, and that could have been fun and easy to do, but they didn't do it really. They just oh, I don't know. I don't understand that, but that's something for the spoiler version of this. Yeah, John Wick 4 is coming out. Now, I don't think that people are looking for things in the movie that aren't there. They're there. If you ever listen to Lana Wachowski talk about the movies, you would understand that the things that they're putting in there are there. In fact, I went looking for those things from the Wachowskis because people didn't understand the other stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, they didn't get it. And so for that reason, it's like, I know this is there. I know something is up with this, you know? And I went looking for it for that reason, you know, I'm trying to find it, but there's some great interviews with Lana Wachowski. If you look up her interview, is this one of them?
Never had it in our careers where it's just like, everyone's like, well, let me sign the check.
Yeah. Right.
And I would just argue with my friends who just worshipped E.T. and everyone's just like, E.T., E.T., yeah. phone home. And I was like, oh my God, it's so...
Elliot lives in my building, by the way.
Does he?
He does. He lives in Old Town. He's shooting, I think it's Mind Games. Henry Thomas, right?
Yeah,
that's his name.
Thomas, yeah,
lives in my building. I'll tell him you said hi.
Give him your best. And anyway, so... In a way, Ridley Scott paved the way. Mm. He actually paid the price for that very aggressive aesthetic. But the other part of aesthetics is that if you do forge this new ground, very often you're remembered. Mm-hmm. And Blade Runner continues to be an important seminal picture because of its aesthetic dynamic. And Yeah, aesthetics continue to, like, it's weird that people don't talk about aesthetics in cinema. I mean, you don't study them. Did you ever hear the word in a class? I'm curious.
We try to, right? We try to, right?
Nobody writes about them. No critic ever mentions the word. I mean, no critic will ever mention the word symbol or the meaning of a symbol.
Right, for sure.
No one will try to identify a symbol. Mm-hmm. And yet, what are movies? They're actually visual images that are symbols, usually of something else. Mm-hmm. And they will never talk about aesthetics. It's like, why? I don't understand it. It's the weirdest silent thing. Like, I saw my wife who makes the most amazing, we have a movie club, and she makes the most amazing double feature. She kind of put together.
Do you see why I like Lana Wachowski? Like, what she's talking about there? I don't know, man. I really like Lana Wachowski. Some of the stuff that she brings up, that right there is interesting. Not a lot of people talk about aesthetics. So I'm like, yeah, you're right. I went to, you know, I took a lot of classes. I know a lot of people took classes, and they do certainly talk about some of it, but that's very interesting. But a lot of people, so I find those things interesting so much that even if the movie isn't the best movie, I found all of the meanings, symbolism, connections, commentary on our world right now in the background of the movie that, you know, and then the symbolism everywhere. I found it aesthetically stimulating. I found this movie crazy stimulating. Almost 95% of people here and the 9K people each day, everything is going to close again. What up, enclosure? Speaking of closing. Yeah, I don't understand it. Omicron is, they're saying Omicron is 45%, 45% less, you know, lethal or dangerous. Oh, my mom's calling me. Let's see what my mom wants. The other brother doesn't look like a woman. Yeah, the other brother, I sort of made a comment. I was like, I wonder if he just followed, you know, because his sister, he was like, I gotta do that too, you know. I don't know. I mean, it's a mean thing to say, but I was kind of just kidding. I don't know. But it felt that way because Lana, you know, sort of transitioned first. And then it felt like Lily was like, yo, I want to do that too. You know, which may not be true. He may have always wanted to be a woman too, and he, you know, she just didn't get there quick enough, as quick or whatever. But I was, you know, I made a joke still, like, hey, you know, I want to, you know, because how many siblings do that? Like, I want to do what my sister does. I want to do what my brother does. You know, they're getting attention. I want attention. But also the one on the right, Lily, who is now Lily, the other Wachowski. We used to call them the Wachowski brothers. Funny enough, now they're the Wachowski sisters. But the one on the right is now Lily. She's the one that's more visceral and mean. I look at her Twitter or whatever, and it's just full of just mean shit, like, towards people that, you know, I don't know. I find the other Wachowski to be very close-minded, this one over here, to be very Lily, to be very close-minded and mean-spirited on Twitter and everywhere. I don't know. But I find Lana on the left here to be very open-minded, curious, and smart. I don't know too much about Lily, about the other Wachowski, you know? This movie comes out 19, 20 years later, right when we are in a global pandemic. Yeah, it's true. It is a little bizarre. No doubt about it. The movie, it feels like the world is telling us something, everybody, and I don't know what that means. The UFOs, the aliens, the Alex Jones, everything he said, and things that come true, but then aren't there. The media lying, the media being unreal, fake. The mind control, the NSA, the sightings, the, you know, JFKs, the 9/11s, the COVID, the hypocrisy, the control, the shutdowns, the camps, our phones, our fingerprint, spy, chip, like everything. What the hell is going on right now? It doesn't, all I know is this doesn't feel right, you know? And it's not that it doesn't feel right, like how chicken pox didn't feel right, or how the flu vaccine maybe didn't feel right, or how the polio vaccine didn't feel right. That is different to me. And I know it's probably because we didn't grow up during some of that and those things, but, you know, it just, this feels different. This feels like a different level of stupid, or a different level of control that we've never seen before. And I don't know what that means, but this movie comments on it quite often in the movie, but indirect yet direct to the story. So that's why I think that this movie is more interesting than it's going to ever be understood to be, in my opinion. I did get one jab. I feel terrible for anyone who took this jab. We're completely conned. I mean, we'll see if something happens to me. I've only had one so far. I just didn't. You know, much like many scientists and doctors are saying, one for a kid is enough. They don't need two, because two is what's been, you know, causing problems. I just felt I didn't need two, but you never know. I mean, we'll see. But what's coming next is the chip. And this is not a tinfoil hat show at this point, to tell you. But that's what's coming. Like, that's is what's coming next. It's not like oh no, let me scare everybody, or let's get scared, or let me I don't care, you know, it's whatever you do is whatever, but that's what's coming next. I don't know if that's good or bad or whatever, but the fact of the matter is that's just what's coming next, you know. The FDA is granting emergency authorization for Pfizer's COVID pill, so that's coming. COVID pill is on its way. I don't know what that 100% means. This is going on right now in Munich, in Germany. People have had enough of the COVID restrictions, it looks like. Why try to control this? You know what I mean? Why are you trying to control a protest of people walking around? You know, but in America, we let people rob the buildings and do whatever they want. We don't care. In Germany, people just want to walk through the street, and you can't do that. You can't gather in the public. Why try to control that? Like, I can understand why to control. Because you could say to me, Joe, why would you want to control people breaking into a Walmart? Well, because that sets the message you can just take people's shit and steal. So that is something worth controlling. Attempting to control your property is worth it, in my opinion. But attempting to control people's right to gather with each other or whatever during this time, this is about control. That's what it is. It's not about saving your property. It's not about protecting property or stopping bad people. This is about control and how much you're willing to take and how much you're willing to be controlled and how much you're willing to be the controller. You're willing to do the work for the controller. So you're willing to get in a pile of people during COVID and push on them and stand in them and potentially all be passing around the virus anyway. So what's the point in trying to control this? You're already there. Unless people are breaking buildings and lighting things on fire, There's no need to control this or to control people. There just isn't. So this is about control. And it's kind of a bizarre and scary one. There's another thing that I wanted to see. So I guess the vaccinations didn't work because I live in a state where 85% of us are vaxxed. In my state, 85% of us are vaxxed, yet we're hitting the same threshold as over a year ago. And they want us now to, they now won't let you into places unless you're vaxxed or masked, or rather both, really. So what was the point in anything? The answer is there is no point. People are fucking stupid. That's what it is. China's got a hard lockdown right now. Here's the microchip stuff. U.S. Army has created a single spike ferritin nanoparticle vaccine, SPFN, against all existing COVID and SARS variants, researchers say. The vaccine is a soccer ball-shaped protein with 24 faces to attach spikes, and human trials are underway right now. They're also working on a chip that would give your vaccination status and a chip reader that would read your vaccination status. So you would have a chip in you, and when you walk in a place, your chip could be scanned, and it would basically, like, after, you know, after 3 or 4 months, run out, and it would know, oh, you need your next booster. You haven't had your next booster yet. Today, Massachusetts, once again, guys, I will repeat again. Massachusetts, we are like 80-something percent vaccinated. We're one of the highest vaccinated places in America. Massachusetts, where I live. Massachusetts reports 7,817 confirmed COVID-19 cases. This is the highest single day total since the start of the pandemic. Now, if you're out there saying, oh, see, it doesn't work, well, it's really going to come down to what are the deaths? You know what I mean? Because here's the thing, there shouldn't be a lot of deaths because, number one, 85% of the people here are vaccinated. So you shouldn't get severely ill and sick because you were vaccinated, right? That's number one. Number two, the Omicron variant is about 45% less lethal than the other ones, according to British studies in other countries that you can see online easily. So that means there's two things going for you, even though the cases are the highest they've ever been here in Massachusetts today. The two things going for you is you're vaccinated, so you shouldn't end up in the hospital. And number two, the Omicron variant is 45% less lethal than the previous Delta variant, right? So just before anybody gets terrified and scared, I think that's a very positive thing. So basically take that 45% and chop that number in half. So if you chop that number of 7,000 in half, that's almost like the equivalent of 3,300 people being sick. But then when you count the fact that 85% are vaxxed, and that should really keep almost all of them out of the hospital, you know, you're down to really worrying about only about 1,000 people or so. But I don't know. That's just me. I don't know math. I'm not a doctor, and I don't know shit. So don't listen to me. But you know, just wondering about this. Joe, you're forgetting that they are counting deaths for anything as COVID. That's true. That's true. But there's also a lot of people getting sick that don't know there's, you know what I mean? They're sick with COVID. They don't even know it or don't care or whatever. And they don't report, you know? So there's a lot of people with it that were never reporting it, so. This is the greatest PSYOP ever devised. I just wonder what's the reason. It's got to be to control us, right? It's got to be so they can control us in some kind of way, right? You know? It's got to be a way to control us. I just don't get why. 100%. You think maybe the aliens took over? Maybe that's why they're going to disclose the aliens to us. Maybe the aliens took over and they needed to get us all injected. But, you know, that just doesn't make sense. It's like, dude, I feel like aliens could easily just snap their fingers and, you know, poison us all easily from the sky with anything. So that doesn't make sense. I'm still confused. I wonder if they needed to get the vaccine into us so that we could, they could turn something on and they could do one of those, like, Project Blue Book or Project fucking Eclipse or whatever, and where they could project an alien image in the sky and hallucinate us, so we all are hallucinating and shit, and we all think it's really real. When they do this weather event or control the weather, or they do that thing where something appears in the sky, you know, I'm just wondering, what is this? Why are they doing this? You know what I mean? Like, what's the reason? This is my mother. Hi.
Are you in the middle of stuff?
Yeah, I'm doing something, but hold on a second. I'm gonna get off the air in a second.
Can you call me back?
Okay, I'll call you back.
All right,
well, I am gonna get out of here. I talked a little bit about the wrestling news earlier. We talked a lot about the Matrix without spoiling it. And then we went into some of this stuff. And I got a little tinfoil-y on you. But yeah, very interesting. Definitely stick around for my spoiler Matrix review. I'm going to get into that where I can really dive into this stuff. And that will be fun. Of course, it's about control. It's always about control. COVID 1984, you're right. I mean, from Pearl Harbor to Project Woodlands or whatever the fuck it was, JFK assassination, all that stuff, the Vietnam War. I mean, this stuff has all been staged and bullshit since the beginning for us to be controlled by something, by somebody for some reason. 9/11. I mean, how is it not clear to everybody that this wasn't real or that this was, that we did this to ourselves for control reasons? Wuhan lab, I mean, owned by our own scientists, funded by our own people. Fauci lied about gain of function. Fauci lied about mask mandates. Fauci lied again the other day about the Wuhan knowledge. They're torturing dogs so they can, like, I mean, dude, I don't even know what this means, but something is wrong. Something is massively wrong right now. And we are waking up in some way. And we're finding out we're all connected in some way. We're waking up in some way. And I know that a lot of reports are that we're in a fourth turn right now of our existence that happens every 100 years, 80 years, whatever it is. That might be true. There's a lot to talk about. But what up, Juan Garibay? What's up, everybody else, man? Thank you guys for being here, hanging out, and listening. Thank you, Brian. Top donation of the stream, man. Thank you so much for the $30, 30 euros. That's about it. I have a lot to say about a lot of things. I hope you guys listen to me on Patreon. Captain Solo, hey, what's up?
Super Chat Party!
Oh, yeah?
911 was staged. I agree.
And I don't think it was staged that they didn't kill anybody. I think we just let it happen or did it on purpose. I don't know why. But it makes sense that, you know, Dick Cheney's whole family benefited from it. The guy was selling the weapons we used. The oil, the Saudi Arabians, we're all friends with that. Like, I mean, like, come on. But, like, we're so stupid that we still argue about that. we are that stupid in this country. We argue about whether, it's like, dude, it's like, are you serious? Anyway, I will talk, spoiler-filled breakdown and talk about The Matrix is on its way on Patreon and on my gaming YouTube channel, Evil Spectrum 3. I hope you guys sub to my other channels like Shame on News, Evil Spectrum 3, and all this stuff. I will see you guys tonight right here for AEW The Review. Will Bray Wyatt show up? Who knows who's going to show up tonight on AEW? Clam Baked, you're not crazy, Joe, because that thought crossed my mind unless we're both crazy. Hey, man, there's nothing wrong with questioning everything, you know? There's nothing wrong in questioning everything. That's what science is, you know? Anytime somebody tells you that by questioning something or questioning anything, you're anti-science, they don't know what that is. So that's crazy. That's awesome, Juan. I'll see you guys tonight for the AEW review. Let's have some fun tonight, man. Let's get weird. Let's get wet. Let's get long.